So what if you could not use type-safe languages? You could not use languages like Java or others that do this checking to prevent memory overflow kind of attacks. What can we do in that case? If you are stuck with, let's say, languages for whatever reason, we talked about a few, where this is not done automatically, what should we be doing? So when we are using these so-called unsafe languages that automatically don't prevent buffer overflows, then it becomes the responsibility of the programmer. If you're writing code, it is your responsibility that you deal with this problem of potential buffer overflows. One way you can do that is by checking all input. Okay, so secure coding mantra is that trust no input. All input is evil, and you should be checking that it conforms to whatever your expectation was. Don't rely on the underlying system to do those, because we're talking about using languages that do not do automatically. So secure coding is an extremely, as you write programs, you write them to implement certain functionality. You may even write them with some performance goals in mind, but at the same time, you need to keep in mind that you have to write them so they cannot be exploited. You have to code securely or use secure coding practices so your program doesn't have the vulnerabilities like the ones we've been talking about. And one way you do that is by checking all input. The other thing that you can do is you can use functions that are safer, that do bounce checking. So remember, in the code, you could have string compare or string copy. You could also have certain side string. So you shouldn't be dealing with a string that is longer than that. So there are functions that put place a limit on the length of the string this function would manipulate. So you can use their number of safer ways to use certain functions that are unsafe, and there are patterns or ways of using those that are safer, where the likelihood of a vulnerability is a lot lower. So these functions, although the language doesn't do it, the functions that you do will do the checking or the bounce checking that we're talking about. And as a result, using those leads to code that is safer, more secure. And the last thing you can do after written some code that's not in a type safe language is to use tools that exist that would actually analyze code that you have written and flag potential vulnerability. The reason, the way they're able to do that is they can look for certain code patterns, they can look for certain unsafe functions, and can warn you that the code fragment that you have where these things appear, an unsafe function appears, could be potentially vulnerable to some sort of exploit, a buffer overflow or something like that. So these tools, you just run your code through these tools, and there's a lot of them that are out there, some commercial, some you can get for free. And these tools, they rely on sort of database of certain kind of patterns that are known to be unsafe. And if they run into your code that matches those kind of patterns, they can flag those, and they can do more sophisticated analysis to potentially discover the kind of vulnerabilities that we're talking about. So there's no excuse for writing code that is not secure. You should be checking your input. You should be using safer functions that do that checking automatically. And then you should run your code through these tools that can flag potential problem spots. And you should go back and look at that and see how you can actually make those potential vulnerabilities go away. One problem with automatic tools is that they may have a lot of false positives, or if they miss out, then they have false negatives. So you can't have tools that will have zero false positives or false negatives, but the tools can certainly help us get rid of many possible vulnerabilities in the process, producing code that is a lot more secure. So even when you are stuck with programming in a language, that's not going to help you much with the kind of attacks or vulnerabilities that we've been talking about. There's certainly things you can do as a programmer who likes to do secure programming by checking input, using safer functions, and then running, checking your code through these tools that we're talking about. And we'll have a long list of these tools, actually, you can go and learn about.